Good morning friends, welcome back to the new lesson, that is array. First we are going to understand what is array. So array is a, I will write here, array is a user defined data type, which stores collection of same type of data. So you can see what is array. So array is a user defined data type which stores collection of same type of data. What is the meaning of that? Let me show you. User defined means we are defining, users are defining using the primary data type, using the int data type, using the float data type, using the character data type. And the benefit of that, let me write that, array is used user defined data type which stores collection of same type of data in a single variable, that is a benefit. So it can store a huge collection of same type of data in a single variable. So same type of means it all array, it will it all will be the integer, or it all will be float, it all will be double, it all will be character. Okay, it doesn't like that it some integer, some float, some characters, all will not. It stores the same type of data, right? So that is called the array. Now the question is that why we need this array. If I ask what is the need of array, simple answer I can say here, suppose you want to store the marks of thousands of children. To store the marks of thousands of the children, we have to take the thousands of the variables. Suppose 1 lakh children are there, then what have to do? We have to take 1 lakh variables. And if one child is having the 5 subjects, so you can think how many variables are required. So it is not a good programming. But array tells, don't worry, we are not going to declare the thousands of the variables or the 100 variables. We will store all this same type of the value in a single variable. So that's why we are using this array, and that's why the need of array. Now we are going to understand types of array. So basically there are two types of the array. One dimensional array, and second is two dimensional array, or we can say multi dimensional. Let me write here multi dimensional array. So one dimensional array, in the sort I can write here 1DA. And here multi-dimensional, it may be one row or one column. So you will see one row, one column, or it may be one row, many columns, or it may be many rows and one column. So that is called the multi-dimensional. So in our syllabus, we have to study the two types of the array, one dimensional array and multi-dimensional array. So let us understand. After understanding what is array, then types of array, now we are going to understand how to declare array. To declare array, we have to use a data type. You can see, let me, this is the comment section. You can see int and data type. This is int is a data type. If you want to store all int, so you write int. If you want to declare all float, so write float. So this first syntax is a data type, then you write the name of the array. Suppose I want to store the roll number, so I write here roll number, then a square bracket, and here I will pick a size. Suppose if you want to store roll number of 5 children, so you give a 5 size. If you want to store of 100, so give a 100. If you want to store the 200, so give the 200. Means we are fixing the size of this array. Means this array will take the maximum of 5 integer type of value, that is a roll number, and then semicolon. So that is called the declaration of array. So I can write here declaration of array. This is called the array declaration of one dimensional. This is one dimensional. So here we are going to study about the first one dimensional. Okay. Now the question is that how to initialize. So when this question comes, so now another two questions are arised. The one, compile time initializations, and second, runtime initialization. Compile time initialization means when you write a code, that time you initialize the value to the array variables. That is called the compile time initialization. Runtime initialization means when you run the program, that time your program will ask to you give a value for that. That is called the runtime initialization. So first we will see runtime compile time initialization, then we will understand the runtime initialization. So let us understand. To that, what have to do? Initializations and declaration both can be done together. So I'm going to teach you both. So here just put equal sign, and then in the curly bracket give the number of roll number. Here I'm giving in 5, 6, 8, 9. You can see it's going to take a maximum 5 because I have given the size as 5. You can't give more than 5. You can give less than 5, but you can't give more than 5. We will see how we can't give. Okay, so this is called declaration of array. I can write here declaration and initialization. Both we are going to do together, and initialization of one dimensional array, right? So this is called. Now how to access this? To access this, we have to write index value. What is index value? So when we declare this roll number 5, so what happened? It stores the 5 slots, means it makes the 5 slots in the computer memory, and each slot gets a value like of it starts from the 7, then 5, then 6, then 8, then 9. And the one property of the array is, or we can say the feature of array, it stores all these array elements in a contiguous memory, right? So now how to access? To access the array elements, we use the index value. Index value means the name of array, you can see, and then in the square bracket we have to give the index value. Index value starts from 0 to n minus 1. The index value of the 7 is 0, for 5 it's 1, and for 6 is 2, and for 8 we have to give 3, and for 9 we have to give the 4, because it starts from 0 to n minus 1. Now how to print it? To print, we have to just write here printf, and this is the int type, so we have to give %d, then comma, and then, and we have to close this, right, and semicolon. So this is the way to printf. But you can see the error is coming because I have not added hash include studio.h and main. That's why this is coming. If I add over here, let me add. So here I'm going to add this hash include and studio, and then we need to add main, because without main our program is incomplete. Then you can see. Now I'm going to move it little bit right side. Yeah, that is good. Then here, Now you can see there is no error, right? So this is called accessing the array elements. Here I will write accessing or fetching the array elements. Array elements, right? Now let me run this. If I run, so you will be see it's going to show the 7. Let me show you. If I run this, you will be see it's going to display the 7. You can see here it's going to display 7. So if I change over there, suppose if I give here 1, so you will be see it's going to print here 5, right? So index value start from 0 to n minus 1. Now this is not a good way to print all. If you want to print all, so then what I have to do, we have to this copy paste, for the first we have to give roll number 0, then for the second roll number 1, for the third. So that is not a easy method, it's not a good method. So what I have to do, we have to use the loop. So let me show you. I will write here for, then I will put here int I is equal to 0, because index value start from 0, I less than 5, and then I plus plus. Why 5? Because the size is, you can see 5. So less than 5 means from the 0 you count it 0 1 1 2 3 4 5, so it will be 5. That's why we have to give less than 5. If you give less or equal 5, so it will be 6. Okay, now instead of giving this z1, we have to give here I, because the value of I will be start from 0, then 1, then 2, then and so on. Now I want to print this. So, and I want to put here backslash t. Let me show you. If I click on this run, you will be see all the array elements are going to be displayed. The array elements which you have given, you can see it's going to display 7, 5, 6, 8, 9. So this is good programming. Means using this loop we are able to print all the array elements. Now I want to show this index value also. So let me do something here. I want to give here percent d, then in the bracket I want to give here percent d, then in the bracket, and then here I want to put equal sign. Let me show, and that is, and here I have given the twice percent d, so I want to give print the value of I and the array element. So I'll give here I here and then comma. Let me run and let me see what is happening over there. Let us see what is going to be happening. You can see the index value 0 is 7, the index value 1 is going 5, index value 2 is going 6, index value 3 is 8. So I hope you are getting very clearly what is index value and where, from where it is going to be a start. Let me put the message over there also, roll number. So that will be a much better than a previous one. Yeah, very good. So you can see roll number 0, this is the index value for the 7, roll number 1, that is a 5. So I hope it is very clear how to declare, how to initialize, how to access the array elements, right? So this is called a one-dimensional array. Now we are discussing about two-dimensional array. Two-dimensional array means one row or one column, or maybe two rows and one column, or maybe two rows, two columns, right? So that is called the multi-dimensional array. Okay, so let us understand how to declare, how to initialize this multi-dimensional. So I'm going to rough this and I'm going to show you. Let me give here numbers. I want to declare her int. So numbers, and the first will for the row. So I want to give here 2, and then this is 2. So this first bracket is for the row and the second for the column. So you can see it will take 2 rows and 2 columns, right? So that is called the declaration of two-dimensional array. Syntax is data type then array name, that is called the variable or array name you can say, and then row size, then we can give the column size. So that is called declaration. Now if you want to initialize, so we can do initialize and declaration both together. So just give equal sign and then give this bracket, curly bracket. So let me give you where I'm giving the first year. I can give like that also, 1, 2. You can see, then here let me give here 3, 4. So you can see this is first row and the second row, right? Let me print it. So maximum it will store the 4 value. So let me run, let me check it, the error is there or not. Here I'm not going to print it, just I want to check it. You can say nothing is there because I have not printed, means error is not there. And now I want to print it, so means how to access, that is good thing. So let me show you how to access. I will use here for loop, or simply I want to print, print, and here I will give percent %d because this is int type, then comma, and then the numbers is array name, and here I want to give 0, then I will give here in bracket 0. So what will happen, it will print the first value, so that is a 1. Let me show you. Very good. Suppose if I give here 0, 1, so what will happen, it will print the 2. If you want to print this, basically what happened, let me make it very clear for you. Yeah, that is good. You can see this is first column, the 1, 3 is the first column and 2, 4 is the second column, and the first row means this is first row and this is the second row. So how this is going to be accessed, let me tell you. If I give 0, 0 means it will take a 1. If I give 0, 1 means it will 2, because okay, if I give here okay 1, 1, then it will show the 3. If I give 1, 0, it will give 3, and if I give 1, 1, it will give 4. Let me show you. Let me give you here 1, 1, and so let's see what is happening here. If I give here 1, 1, then what will happen? The 4 should be printed. Let's see. Yeah, very good. And if I give here 1, 0, so it will print 3. So I hope you got how this is going to be work. Very good. So this is it, how this is going to be work. Let me clear it. I want to make you understand. Let me show you how this is going to be work. If 0 means this is going to indicate the row and this is going to indicate the column. So if I give 0, 0 means what is happening, it's going to print 1. If I give 0, 1, so it is going to print 2, right? If I give here 0, 1, right? If I give here 0, 1, let's see what is going to be printed. 0, 1. So you can see 2 is going to be printed, right? And so 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 2, and if I give here 1 and then 0, so what will happen, 3 will be printed. This is row number 1 means row number 2, because they start from the 0, right? You can see it's going to print it 3. And if I give here 1, 1 means it's going to print 4. So I hope you got it. But this is not a good technique to print. So what have to do, children? We have to use here for loop. Very good. So let me write here for loop int I is equal to 0, then I less than here the array size is row is the first 2, then I plus plus. You can see children here, two rows and two columns, means column rows and columns. So we have to use a two loop. So let me show you. If I write here, this is for row, the first, and then we have to use here one more loop over here for column. So I will write here 2 and j plus plus. So if two dimensional arrays are there, so we have to use a two loop, one for row, another for column. So I'm going to just show you. Now you can see. So that is the thing we have to keep in our the mind. If two dimensional array, so we have to use the two loops for printing the this array elements, because one for we have to take the row, another for we have to take the columns. So I hope it is very clear. So instead of this 10, now we have to give here I, because the row number is going to be stored in the I and the column number is going to be stored in the j. So now let me print and let me show you how this is going to be work. So let me put here t, so that it will put a space, and let me print it. Very good, very good. So you can see that this all 1, 2, 3, 4s are going to be printed. I want to do something special. I want to print like this 1, 2, 3, 4, like a matrix format. So what I have to do, friends? So here I want to just break a line. So in the outer loop, so I will write here printf, and here I will put backslash n. Let me show you what is happening when I print this. Very good, very nice. So you can see, as I declared over there, as I initialize over there, same way it is going to be print. If you don't want much space, fans, so what I have to do, instead of this t, just put over there 2. If you want 2 space, if you want 3, so put the 3. Let me show you how this is going to be printed. Very nice, very nice, right? So if you want more space, just give here another number, that is 4. Don't give in a decimal, because this is the integer. Very good. Let's see. Very good. So I hope you all are going to understand the two dimensional array. So here we understood array. So let me summarize. Array, I told, array is the user defined data type which stores same type of various collection of data. Let me remind, it stores same type of data and in a collection, in a single variable. So that's why I have written, you can see definition, array is a user defined data type which stores collection of same type of data. You can't give, suppose for example, if I give over here 1.5, so let's see what is happening over there, will work or not. Let me show you. You can see the 0.5 is not going to be visible. Why? Can you tell me the reason? Because it stores same type of data, but I have given 1.5, that is a float data. So keep in the mind, friends, if you want to store all floats, so instead of int, give a float. So that is called same type of data. Now we are going to understand a string array. Let us understand, friends, what is a string array. So I'm going to rough this and I'm going to show you. Let me show you. Here I'm going to write here and include, okay, studio dot h, and here I want to show you something special for you. Let's see that. Yeah, I want to give here char and my name, that is my variable name, and size 20. Then if I write here, let me write my name Dhananjay, and if I print this, let me show you, printf, and here I am going to print %c, and then I want to print here this my name, and I want to put 0 here. So what will happen, friends? You will see the d is going to be printed, because this is a array. This letters are going to be stored in a array concept. The first d is going to store in the first contiguous memory, and second is going to store in the second contiguous memory. So let me print and let me show you how this is going to be printed. You can see the error is coming. Why the error is coming? So you can see I have not given this semicolon, right? Now let me run it and let me show you. You can see it's going to print the d. But if I want to print this all, so let me put here this for loop, and here I want to put int I is equal to 0, I less or equal, let me give here not that the size is maximum here. Let me count how many sizes here. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 so 9, and then the I plus plus, and here let me give here 10, right? Now I'm going to print this here. Instead of this 0, I will give here I, and let me run, let me show you. My complete name will be printed. Let me put here \n, then you will understand. Where, so you can see that my name is going to be printed here, right? So this name is also a group of characters, or that is also stored in the form of array. So I hope you got this. If you want to print, okay, so many tasks we can perform using the array. We will see in a separate video the array questions answers. In this video we will understand the array concept. When I make another video, so there I will take questions related to array. Okay, so that can give you more power, and you will understand how the array is going to be used. In this video, just we are going to clear out the concept. So here we understood this. You can declare this name like that also. Let me show you. Char, and I want to instead of this, just a minute. I want to give like that. That is also possible. Let me show you. D, then H, then A, then N, A, then N, then J, A, Y. So you can see I have given in the array. So I hope it is very clear. Instead of giving this without a quit, I am giving the single quotation, because this is the character. If the int is there, so there is no need to give this. You can see DHANANJAY I have given. So let me print it, let me show you. You can see the same result is coming, right? If I remove this, so you can see the my name will be printed. Let me show you. You can see. So I hope you got it, meaning of a string array. Now we are discussing about runtime initialization. So let me show you, friend, what is runtime initialization. Here I'm going to declare a float, then marks. And here I'm giving 5. Right? And I want to show the message to the user. So let me put over here print int I is equal to 0, I less than 5, I plus plus. Here I want to show the message printf marks, and marks for the subject, and in the bracket I want to put here this. Okay, and comma, and I will put over here I. Right, scanf and percent d, and then we have to give it ampersand and the array name, that is the marks, and here I. So what will happen when I run this program? So it will ask the 5 subject marks. Okay, so let me run it and let me check it what is happening over there. Let me put here backslash n, that is more okay. So you can see asking the marks for the subject 0. Subject 0 means the first subject. So if I give here 78 out of 100, I am giving. Asking the mark for the subject 1 means subject 2, 50. Marks for 3, marks for. So you can see when I run this program, so that time it is asking the value for the this array. So that is called the runtime initialization. So while running this program, it will ask the this value which you want to store in the marks. So this is called the runtime initialization. Here I want to do something. Let me print here 1, because I want to print subject 1, not a 0, right? So that will be much better. After printing this, I want to, after getting this value, I want to print this. So let me print here. I'll put here one more for loop over here. Int I is equal to, I is already taken, so I'm take the j is equal to 0, then j less than 5, then j plus plus. I want to print this all the marks which I have taken, right? So just I will let me write here printf, and I will add here marks of subject. I want to write here 1, so I will put in the bracket percent d, that will be dynamic, right? And here I will put equal sign so that it will be okay. And then I want to print this, so I will write here marks, then in the bracket I will put here I, because the marks has been stored inside that, you can see. And here this is, here I want to put percent d float, and here we have to pass 2, the one I plus 1, and then that is okay. I want to put in the bracket, not I, it's a j.
and here will be also a j.
So let me print this. Let me clear what is the meaning of that. Marks of the subject, that is the message, and person d, what will happen over here, friend? It will print the j plus 1, means 0 plus 1 1, the subject 1. Same way it will go for increasing, it will print the marks of the subject 2. So that's why I have given this. And this percent f means this marks which I have a store inside that. So let me run it and let me check it how this is going to be work. So you can see, friends, it's going to ask. Yeah, very good. So 78 marks for the subject 2, 56, 99, 70, 56. You can see. Now what is happening over here? You can see something is going to be error over there. So why this is going to be displayed? Let me show you what problems are happening over there. Let me put over there backslash n first and let me check it. And I want to print up to two decimal places, so I'll put 0.2. You can see, friend, this is a flow type, so here we have to give the f, not d. That's why that problems are occurring, because if there is a float, so we have to take a percent f. If there is a percent d integer, so we have to take the percent d. So let me run and let me check it. Yes, good. 77, 88, 99, and 50 and 45. Now you can see what is going to be happen. Let me make it a little bit bigger. Now let me run it. Yeah. 77, 88, 99, 54, and 69. You can see, very good. It's going to show the marks for the subject 1 and 2, 3, 4. It's working nicely. So here we understood this, right? This is called the runtime initialization. I mean, when we run, that time it will ask the values for this array which we have declared over there, right? Now let me take one question over there. Suppose I want to find the percentage of this, right? Then what I have to do, friends? Let me show you. We have to declare one more variable over there. One variable I want to take, float, and I will take here total marks first. Total marks, let me put here this underscore, and so here I want to add this, all the total marks. So what will I do? I will add this marks inside this. Okay, how will I add? Let me show you. Just I will put the code over there. Just I will do total marks is equal to total marks plus marks I. So what will happen, friends? Whatever the marks, by default nothing is given, so zero is given. If it is not there, so it will be a store. Let me put here 0. So what will happen? The first time 0 plus whatever you have inserted, that will be that should be here. Let me put here after taking this, we have to print, right? Okay, so let me print this total marks. So I'll write here printf. And here the message, total marks of 5 subject and here I want to put appropriate message. So %2F, and then I'll give you a total marks. Now let me run and let me check it. Let me run it. Let me give you 77, 88, 99, and 56, and 85. You can see it's going to take all the 5 subject marks, then going to print it, and it's going to add it, total marks of 5 subjects, right? Now let me find the percentage, because I told that we have to find the percentage also. So what I have to do, friends? It's very simple. The total marks has been taken over here. So here I want to take one more variable for storing the percentage marks. So I will write here float, and I will write here like that, and then 0. Why I'm going to store the 0? Because if I don't give any value initially, so what will happen? It will take garbage value. Garbage means that is totally meaningless. So better for us, we need to give a initial value, that is 0. Now I want to calculate that percentage marks. So I'll write here is equal to, you know, formula, total marks multiply 100 divided by out of. So 5 subjects, so it will be 500. Now let me print this percentage marks also. So I will write here printf, and here I will write here percentage marks, total percentage, or simply percentage marks. Yes, and here %2F up to 2 decimal places, that's why. Yeah, that we have to do. And let me put over here backslash n, and here also I want to put the backslash n that I wanted. So here I have given a one example, or we can say a one questions. Okay, write a Java, write a C program to get the marks of 5 subject, add it, and find the percentage using the array. So that is a question. So here we are going to complete that. Let me show you. Yeah, it's asking the first subject marks. Let me give it 45, then 99, then 65, then 78. Then 99 again. You can see here, friends, going to display total marks of 5 subjects 386, and the percentage marks is 77.20. if you want to show in percentage, so let me show something for you. It's okay now. So here we understood the complete array concept. Nothing, I think almost all concepts we have finished. Thank you for watching. In next video, we will take questions, answers related to this array, and we will solve that, and that time also it will be very important for you. Thank you for watching that. Thank you so much. Bye bye. See you.